And joining me now is Senator Saxby Chambliss of Georgia. He is the ranking Republican on the Senate Intelligence Committee. He also serves on the Armed Services Committee. Senator Chambliss, thanks for being here. These military advisors that President Obama announced, up to 300 of them that will work alongside the Iraqi military, will that be enough?
Well, I think that's a real question because we don't know the answer to that. Here's what the president didn't say, Jake, and that is he didn't tell us what his goal is and what's his plan to achieve that goal. He did say that he may send in up to 300 Special Forces folks to carry out a joint operation with the Iraqi security forces. And are they going to be there in an advisory capacity only, or are they there to carry out joint operations? I don't know the answer to that. But 300 Americans is not going to solve the problem of stopping the advance of this group that is more extreme than literally core al-Qaeda.
What do you think he should have done then if 300 special operation troops are not enough? Do you think there should be airstrikes? Do you think we should send in ground troops? What would you prescribe?
Well, listen, the president's got good military advisors around him, and they're the ones that actually need to be telling him. But clearly, particularly from an intelligence standpoint, we need to carry out a surge to be able to provide the president with the right kind of intelligence relative to these ISIL folks. We don't know where they all are now. We don't know the exact number of them, but the intelligence community is still gathering that kind of information. Based on that and based on what the president said, I assume he's not going to carry out airstrikes, that they're going to be more targeted types of strikes, which indicates to me that he's probably thinking more about drones than he is about sending F-16s or some tactical aircraft in there.
Senator, as I'm sure you know better than I, the American people are very skeptical of sending any military troops into Iraq. Why do you think there is a national security interest in preventing ISIS or ISIL from taking Baghdad, in stopping what looks to be something like a civil war in Iraq?
Well, clearly, Americans have paid a heavy price in Iraq. We made a lot of gains and provided a lot of subsistence to the Iraqi people so that they could govern themselves. All of that seems to be falling apart now. All of the gains that we made, all of the sacrifices that America and Americans made seems to be for naught. I think it's important that we ensure that American lives were not lost for nothing. But secondly, our economy is still oil-driven, and it's important that in that part of the world, not just in Iraq, but in that part of the world, that we have as much stability as possible. We've already seen the ISIL folks make an attempt to overrun the largest oil refinery in Iraq. There's a question as to whether they've been successful at that or not, but if that does happen, then you're going to see the price of gas in America increase more than it should. So there are a number of national security interests that America has in the whole region. Iraq happens to be the country now that's at the center of that stability issue in the region.
Senator, I just want to press you on the point you made when you said that one of the reasons why we should be sending troops and having more U.S. military activity in Iraq is because we are so dependent upon oil and we need stable and hopefully lower oil prices. That's an observation that I think might ring upsetting with a lot of Americans, the idea that we would go to war for cheaper gasoline.
And we should not go to war for cheaper gasoline, but our economy is driven by that, and that's why providing stability in that part of the world is important to us. We never went into Iraq on the very first day with the idea that oil was an issue, but stability in the region is important.
You're on the Senate Intelligence Committee. How much of a threat do the terrorists with ISIS or ISIL pose not just to American interests and not just to American allies, but to the United States homeland itself? How concerned is the intelligence community that these terrorists are capable of striking in the United States?
We know that in Syria, for example, an American strapped a suicide vest on himself and went in and blew himself up and killed a number of other people. My biggest fear and the thing that keeps me awake at night is that we're going to have more homegrown terrorists do that same thing in the United States. We don't need them, these individuals, to have the opportunity to train as to how to do that in places like Iraq and Syria.
Senator Saxby Chambliss, thank you so much.
Sure. Good to be with you, Jake.